The overwhelming feedback I was getting was we struggle to find really great engineering, programming talent here in Australia to help them build these amazing businesses that are going to change the world. And I started looking at what the root cause of that might be, and it came down to the fundamental gap in the market that nobody is teaching coding in schools. It's not part of the national curriculum yet. And I thought, well, instead of standing on the sidelines, why not go and help solve the problem?
75% of jobs in the future are going to require STEM skills. So if we don't have the people with the skills, they won't be able to do the jobs and they won't be able to take advantage of the new technologies, and hence our businesses won't, and hence the country won't do well. We have to be quite deliberate about what we do, and that's why I'm so passionate about getting those skills into the education system.
We're about to see automation take over so much of what happens. You know, 44% to 55% of all jobs that we do today are going to get done better, more efficiently by a robot or a computer. What becomes important is your ability to interact with the computer and the robot and make it do what you want it to do. And that means coding.
What we saw at the end of the 1800s, beginning of the 1900s, was everybody needed to learn to read for the first time. And what we're seeing at the end of the 1900s and the beginning of the 2000s, everybody needs to learn code.
Coding is pretty important to me because in the future most jobs are going to be based around coding. You can use your creativity to like just make all sorts of games and apps and whatnot.
Well, it gives you opportunities to code, and coding is quite nice and fun. Maybe architecture, because I think you could probably build programs which calculate a good kind of building.
Well, I think coding's fantastic for young girls. I coded as a kid. I'm so pleased to see a new generation of young girls learning to code. It's so important. It's absolutely helped me because computational thinking is a skill that really carries with you in whatever discipline you're in. Now, I ended up as a lawyer, but I have to say that being able to break complex things down into simple parts, which is really part of computational thinking, has always been really beneficial to me.
I find digital capability is a huge leveler for every part of minority society, whether you're from a remote area, whether you have a learning difficulty, girls or boys. It's a great leveler for everyone. One of the first ever code clubs we set up was at a school in Lakemba, so a Western Sydney school where 80% of the children don't speak English as a first language. That code club is now massively oversubscribed. The kids absolutely love what they're doing, and it's completely changed their perception of STEM, so science, technology, engineering and maths, thinking originally that it wasn't for them, and they've actually realised that it is for everybody as a result of just going through Code Club. What an awesome outcome that is.
It's really important for me because later when I'm older, I know what to do with the computers and I know how to fix things up.
For the other kids who want to learn code, I recommend that start off easy and keep practicing if you can't figure it out.
I feel so elated and joyful to see them get involved so much into creating something new, and the happiness on their faces is just unimaginable. They're just happy.
What I do see is more things like self-confidence. I see resilience, I see teamwork, I see cooperation, I see them talking to each other in a manner that's respectful. I see all those skills, the really necessary great skills to become a really good citizen in life.
The thing about Code Club Australia's approach is that they tackle it in two ways. One, they're educating teachers, so they're enabling teachers to deliver code in curriculum, which is just awesome. And the other part of it is they're enabling communities to actually teach code as well and start up their own code club, so it's that two-pronged approach.
I'm not training these teachers to be programmers. This is all about preparing people to have the skills. And the end result isn't just making programmers. It's about digital literacy, it's about computational thinking, and these are going to be important skills in many different roles in the future.
Yeah, I think it's really important. You know, a lot of different countries around the world, different governments are really treating it quite seriously. It should really be front and centre on the agenda in terms of let's get our youth engaged in technology as soon as possible.
Code Club Australia offers programming completely for free. We train teachers and volunteers for free. We offer the curriculum and programming for free. And we provide the framework all for free. The reason we keep it free is so that every child has access.
We can't predict what this skill is actually going to give to these children and how they're going to use it. There was one child, and he said it better than any other way I could say it. He said, coding's like a superpower. I get to go create the future with this new skill. That's amazing. You never know what these children are going to do, and equally you never know how much it's actually meaningful to them in terms of giving them confidence, giving them a creative outlet that they wouldn't otherwise have. It absolutely isn't just learning to code.
There was one story where a little kid mentioned that, you know, he'd never thought he could be an inventor. And that was his direct sort of response from learning how to code, that he thought he could now be an inventor. This is like an 8-year-old kid. It was just sensational. So I think for me, it's the kids' stories, and you hear stories that just, yeah, they want to make you cry because it's obviously working. It's a fantastic program.